Hey guys, what's up? This is Sean Heather, and in this video we are going to do a benchmarking test on Nokia 7 Plus smartphone. It comes with Snapdragon 660 processor, Adreno 512 GPU, 4GB RAM, 64GB internal storage, 6-inch Full HD Plus screen, and it runs on Android Oreo OS. So let's see how much all of these hardware specs are going to contribute in the benchmarking test. The benchmarking applications we got today here, they are Android Benchmarking, Basemark OS 2, Basemark X, Geekbench 4, and Quadrant Standard. We have already performed all of these tests to save your time, and we are going to have a look on the test result, and we will also compare the performance of Nokia 7 Plus with other smartphones. So let's start it. So first of all, let's start with Quadrant Standard, and the score is 34,404, and this is really very nice score considering the hardware specs of the device. Most of the flagship smartphones, they are getting around 40 to 42,000, so considering the price difference between a mid-range smartphone and a high-end smartphone, and also the hardware specs, the performance of Nokia 7 Plus in Quadrant Standard is really good. And you can also have a look on this list, few old smartphones, pretty old actually, just to get an idea. Or you can watch our previous benchmarking videos, and then you can compare the performance of Nokia 7 Plus with other smartphones. Now let's have a look on Android Benchmarking, and the score is 140,436, and this is also a very nice score. Most of the mid-range smartphone in this price segment, they are achieving around 100,000 or 110,000 max, but Nokia 7 Plus scored 140,436, and this is really impressive. And if you go to the individual test score tab, you can see that in all of these tests, performance of Nokia 7 Plus is really good, especially when it comes to CPU performance. You can see that it says it defeated 99% of users, so this score is really good. And also at the top, you can see that it says it defeated 42% of users in overall benchmarking test score. And then the best performance is coming from UX. This is an Android One smartphone, so the user interface and the OS is very lag free and smooth, and also it's contributing in the overall benchmarking score. And if you go back from here and go to the ranking tab, you can compare the test score result of Nokia 7 Plus with other smartphones. So you can see that at the first position, it's 264,769, more than 124,000 points compared to our Nokia 7 Plus. Let's scroll down and have a look on the position of our device. So it's at 49th position, as you can see here, right below the Zook Z2 and Xiaomi Mi Note 3. So if you have used either Zook Z2 running on Qualcomm Snapdragon 820 or Xiaomi Mi Note 3, then you will get the idea about the performance of the device. But again, considering the price and the hardware specs, from the perspective of a mid-range smartphone, performance of Nokia 7 Plus is quite good. And now let's go back from here and let's have a look on Basemark OS 2. And the score is 2376, and this is also quite good. The most high-end smartphones, they are getting around 3500 maximum, and you can have a look on the individual test score for system, memory, graphics, and web browsing. You can see once again the most points, the score is coming from the CPU, from the system, and after that it's memory, then graphics, and the web browsing. As I said earlier, you can watch our previous videos to compare this result with other smartphones. Now let's have a look on Basemark X. It's a gaming benchmarking test giving the idea about the gaming capability and the GPU performance, and the score is 36,505, and this is really impressive. The high-end smartphones, they score around 44,000-45,000, and other smartphones in the same price segment of Nokia 7 Plus, they score around 20,000-25,000, and Nokia 7 Plus has scored 36,000, so this score is really impressive. But we will do a detailed gaming review of Nokia 7 Plus, and then we will see that how good this device is going to perform in real life scenario while playing few of the most high-end games, not only in the benchmarking test. But right now, the performance of the device is looking really promising. for gaming. And now let's have a look on the last test for today, and that's Geekbench 4. So for single core it's 1641 and for multi-core it's 5946, and in both of these tests performance of Nokia 7 Plus is impressive. As I'm comparing with the high-end smartphones, they are achieving around 1900 or max 2000 in single core and around 7000 in multi-core. So considering that, performance of Nokia 7 Plus is really nice and impressive. And if you go to the single core tab here, you can see and compare the result with other smartphones. So Samsung Galaxy S7 scored 1806. It's a flagship smartphone. It was launched 2 years back, a bit old now, but again, it's pretty good in terms of performance. And our Nokia 7 Plus is giving a good competition to it, as you can see here. Also, if you go down, you can see that Xiaomi Mi 5 and OnePlus 3, they scored around our Nokia 7 Plus. Both of them, they got Snapdragon 820. So the performance of Snapdragon 660 processor is as good as Snapdragon 820, as you can see here. And if you go to the multi-core, once again, you can compare the result. You can see that this time the best performance is coming from our Nokia 7 Plus, and Galaxy Note 7, S7, S7 Edge all are below Nokia 7 Plus in terms of benchmarking test score. So even in Geekbench 4, performance of Nokia 7 Plus is nice and impressive. But these are just benchmarking test score. As I said, we will have a look on the real life performance in the detailed gaming review and the detailed review of the device. So that's all for now, friends. Thanks for watching the video, and do not forget to subscribe the channel for more videos, tips and tricks and hands-on reviews like this. I'll see you guys next time, and you can also get in touch with me on Twitter, Facebook and Instagram by visiting the links given in the description. Have a nice day.